Hello, today we will install Oracle 19c, the latest version in 2019, into Windows 10. First of all, we need to go to Oracle website to download the Oracle database software. You run down to the download. Then we are looking for the database. We have few version of Oracle database here. Oracle database 12c, 18c, and the latest version is 19c. We have many version of Oracle 19c, the version for Windows, version for Linux, version for Solaris, IBM, SBUX, for example. We need to install Oracle to Windows, so we will choose this version. You need to click on Accept the License Agreement, then click here to download. After a few minutes for waiting to download, I have the Oracle software here, around 3 GB. I put that compressed file into this folder you see, application Oracle product 19c, the DB Home 1, this Oracle Home, and I extract this file directly to this folder. After extract Oracle software to Oracle Home directory, this is our Oracle Home directory. We will go to next step to execute Oracle installer. This is our installer. We can double click here to execute it. This is the Oracle installer interface. So we have almost 16 steps to install Oracle software. In the first step, we need to choose to install software only, install software and create the first instance. I will choose this option to install software and create the first instance. Next step, we need to choose to install in desktop class or server. I will choose the server because I need to test all new feature of Oracle database. We can choose advanced install to see all step of installation. We have two versions in this installation. The first one is the Android edition. We have full feature of Oracle Database 19c in this version. The second one is Standard Edition 2. Some new feature of Oracle will not available on this. For testing, we will choose this option to see on feature of Oracle. However, if you use for your business, you need to consider because the license for Enterprise Edition is much expensive more than Standard Edition 2. On this step, we need to choose to create a virtual account. This means the account for Windows. We choose the existing one. I will choose the first option. Oracle installer will create that account. On this step, we will need to choose Oracle base location. Oracle base, I will choose on the first, very first of Oracle Home. This is my Oracle Home directory. So the location for Oracle base should be Oracle. So Oracle base will be application Oracle, then Oracle Home will be application Oracle product 19c and DB Home 1. This step, we will choose what type of database instance. Oracle already create some template for Oracle database with some configuration. For the first, we will use for zero purpose or transaction processing. The second one is config for a data warehousing. I need to use for zero purpose, so I choose the first option. In this step, we will choose the global database name or instance name. We can use this name, this default name of Oracle database, ORCL. We can check on this to create the database as the new feature of Oracle database TLC. It's called a multi-tenant database. Keep in mind that in this option, we need to pay each license for Oracle. If we uncheck, we will create the database like a traditional database, one instance and one database. I just need to create a traditional database one, so I uncheck this option. Right here, you can choose the memory for Oracle instance. We have two kinds of configuration here. If we check on this, Oracle will use memory tactic to create the memory. This is the new feature of Oracle 11z. However, sometimes it have some problem with this feature, so it is recommend to undo this. We will go back to use the option of Oracle 10z, this Oracle 10z option. We will select between SGA and BGA in two parameters. We will have two options with selectly. I don't need to use too much space for this instance, so I choose around this 700 megabyte. Oracle will automatic config for SGA and same like that, and BGA. We can reconfig it later after we create database. In this tab, we will choose the character set. Default character set will be UTF-8. Then symbol schema, if you need to use some schema like HR or cell history, for example, we will need to check on this. Then next, we will have two options to store our data file. The first option is store a regular file in our drive. Oracle will recommend this location from Oracle base, then next to Aura Data. You can choose the second option if you have Oracle ASM on your computer. But on this installation, I just install database only. I don't have any ASM on my computer, so I choose the first option. Then if you need to monitoring and administration your database via Oracle Enterprise Manager Cloud Control, you can register your database with the Enterprise Manager Cloud Control here. If you don't have it, just uncheck. Recovery location.
If we check here, Oracle will create a folder. It's called Oracle Base here. Recovery area to store some file like archive log file. If we turn on archive log mode, or flatbed block, if we turn on flatbed database mode, or something like that. We can check here, and if we don't like it, after we create database, we can reconfig to remove it. That's doesn't matter. So this step, we need to choose the password for assist and system user. I'm a bit of lazy, so I check to here and create the same password for assist and system. This is my password. So I go to next step. Oracle will need to verification our information on our server. So it look everything is okay now. So after few step, is 15 step, you can choose to save our configuration on 15 step to one file that called RESTBONE file. Then next, if you install on another computer, you just need to load this RESTBONE file only. We don't need to go to step by step like this. It's very helpful if you need to install for Classroom or something like that. But for this, I don't need this because I installed on only one computer, so I don't need to save that RESTBONE file. So I click here to install database, and we just need to wait to wait for installation. You can see some step here: install, setup Oracle Base, and on this last step, Oracle installation will create the first instance. You can click on details here to see what happened with the installation. After the installation is completed, we can go to Windows Service to see the instance there. So we scroll down and we can see Oracle Service. The first one is Oracle DNS Listener. We need this service to connect to Oracle database from remote home. And the second one is Oracle Instant. You can see the service name Oracle Service and instant name. Our instant name is ORCO. It's running now, so we can connect to this instant. We can use the command line like this. SQL plus to connect to our database, a sysdba. So it connect to our database. You can see our database version is 19C. To check the name, we can query name from v$database. or we can see the list of username. We have lots of user here. If you remember, we have installed the sample schema. This one of sample schema, HR schema. So we could try to query some data from here. Country, for example. That's the installation seem completed. So you can ready to connect to your database to use it to check the new feature. Hope you're doing well. Thank you.